isn't it? Could be that we got this gift from someone specifically so we could solve the case. And again, you managed to go inside the TV and get your persona first. I feel like, as long as you're with me, I can find the culprit and crack this case. Well, let's do our best.
The persona ability is the power to control one's own heart, and the heart is strengthened through bonds. As you form bonds by becoming involved with others, your own social links will gradually develop. The power of these social links is what will determine your persona's abilities.
About yesterday? We're sorry we worried you.
Never mind that. Is Yukiko still not here?
Huh? Yukiko-san? No. At least, I haven't seen her today.
Oh, man. What should I do? Hey, is that stuff you were talking about for real? You know, all that about how people showing up on the Midnight Channel is related to that other world.
Oh, we were just talking about that. We're thinking of checking it out later.
The person on TV yesterday? I think it was Yukiko. That kimono looked like the one she wears at the inn, and she wore it during that interview a few days ago, too. I got worried, so I emailed her last night, but she hasn't responded. I called her earlier in the evening, though, and she said she'd be at school today.
Calm down. We get the picture. And you still haven't heard from her?
No! What's that supposed to mean? Wait, are you saying Yukiko was thrown in there?
We don't know yet for sure. We should check to see if she's safe first. Give her another call.
Voicemail picked up. She's not answering.
Are you serious? Then is Yukiko-san inside that place?
Stop it! Something must have come up, like an errand or something. Oh, or she might be helping at the inn. She wouldn't be able to answer herself if that's it.
Yeah, but would she skip school for that?
Well, I'll give the inn a call. I've got the number here somewhere. Come on, Yukiko. Pick up. Oh, is this Yukiko? Thank God she's there. I see. It was nothing. I'll email you again later. She was over at the inn. She said they had a big group reservation and she had to help out. Yeah. Oh, now that I think about it, this has happened before, too. At least once a year. She said she'll be at the inn tomorrow, too. For crying out loud, Yosuke, you got me worried over nothing. She was totally fine. And you were all, "Is Yukiko-san inside that place?"
Sorry, but there is a reason we thought that.
Oh yeah? What?
Well, we thought people show up on the Midnight Channel because they're already over in that world. I mean, it makes sense, right? People show up on TV because they're inside the TV. But Yukiko-san's still here in our world. We might want to see what this is about. All right, let's meet up at Juness after school. Okay, I think that's more than enough about my sorry escapades.
If I hadn't seen the place firsthand, I'd never have believed a story like that.
Yeah, no kidding. Anyways, we need to know what's going on inside.
How? By talking to that Teddy guy?
Yeah. Too bad there's so many customers around. I forgot there's a sale in the electronics department today. I got it. Come here a sec. Try sticking your hand in and calling him over. I bet that bear's wandering around the entrance anyway. Hey, Chie, stand over here. Make a wall with me.
A wall?
What's wrong?
Shh! Not so loud, you idiot! Dude! Is that a bite mark? Are you okay? Oh, come on. Don't cry. Sheesh, that stupid bear must have done it. Hey, you. We know you're in there.
Oh, is this a game?
No, it's not a game. Can you sense anyone inside there right now?
Who's anyone? I'm a lonely little bear, like always. This land feels so barren.
Shut it! So there's no one inside? You're sure?
I'm not lying! My nose is running as good as ever.
I'm gonna go warn Yukiko anyway. Since she'll be busy this weekend helping out at the inn, I doubt she'd go anywhere alone, but still.
Yeah. You'll walk with her to school on Monday, right?
Sure. I'll go pick her up at her house.
Maybe we'll find out more on tonight's Midnight Channel. Cross your fingers that this is all just a misunderstanding. What's your cell number? I'll call you when I watch it tonight. Alright, don't forget to watch tonight.
Looks like we found all we're gonna find here. And we've still got nothing that points directly to a suspect.
We don't even know if this is a homicide.
Well, what else could it be? There's no way a body could end up like that by accident.
I know. We haven't found the cause of death for the first Vic. Now we got a second one just like it. If this is a murder case, there's no doubt we're dealing with a single perp. But if that's true, what the hell's going on?
You know, I thought at first this all spun out of that love triangle.
No, that singer, Misuzu Hiragi, has a solid alibi. She was performing overseas, and her phone records prove it. And remember, the only reason the scandal went public was because Hiragi herself broke it to the media. No one would put themselves under suspicion that way if they had murder on their mind.
Got a point there.
Same with Taro Namatame, her husband. No matter how much we shake him down, nothing links him to the murders. He's been working in the city for the past 6 months. Seems he was here recently because of the scandal, but he was swamped with work back home at the time of the incident. There are eyewitnesses and other evidence placing him at his office the night that Mayumi Yamano died. And we can't find anything that shows Yamano making contact with Namatame before or after her disappearance.
You hear Namatame's career has also been killed stone dead? He's been fired from his position as secretary. He's practically as much of a victim as the Yamano girl.
Yeah, I agree. Then we have the second case, regarding Saki Konishi. She's the one who discovered Yamano's corpse. I don't buy the killer shutting her up as a possible motive. She was killed well after she reported the body, and the culprit didn't hide her. It's like they were meant to be found. The only other connection is that she attended the same school as the daughter of the inn where Yamano was holed up. But that hardly points to a motive. Coincidences like that are common in a town as small as ours.
Yeah, I heard about that angle on the news, too.
What? Is the story about the inn out already?
Okay, I got it. How's this? Maybe there was something about the corpse that only Saki Konishi knew. And our perp killed her to keep whatever it was from leaking out.
Either way, all we can do now is keep investigating anyone involved with the victims. Our perp. It has to be someone in Inaba.
Oh, is your detective's intuition at work?
Welcome home!
Yukiko-san for sure. It looked like her, and I mean, she even said her name. But didn't the stuff she was saying sound weird? And she looked like she was on some low-budget TV show. Was it like this before, too? What's going on? Sunday, so let's meet up at Juness first thing in the morning.